Word or to indicate ascent. The second word is gradually, taking place in stages over an extended period of time. Next word is lean. The first is thin, containing little fat, and second is moving into a moving into a sloping position. Like in English, we say she is leaning against the wall. I come to the next word, arrangements. It means plans for future action. And the last word is smoothed. It means the first meaning is making smooth, and second is free from projections. Now, students, I come to the second part, that is, use the following idioms in sentences of your own. There are a lot of sentences that you can make. Let me give you one or two important uses of them. I take up the first important idiom, take off. Take off, in Hindi we say utar dena. So I can make a sentence, when I came inside my house, I took off my raincoat, or she took off her expensive dress after having returned from the party. The second is to start the whole house. To start the whole house means you disturb everyone in the whole house. Uncle Podger was in the habit to start the whole house. You involve everyone, you disturb everyone. Next is to look for, dhoondna. I'm looking for my lost book. The mother is looking for her child. When I went to station to receive my friend, I was looking for her. The next idiom is to get up. That is, we generally used even as a mark of respect. When elders come to a place, we are supposed to get up and wish them. Another thing we say, in the morning one should get up. It is very important for us to get up while the elderly members come to us. It is a mark of respect. The next idiom is to give up. To give up means surrender kar dena, chhod dena. So what should you give up? Give up bad habits, bad company, alcohol, gambling, bad language, etc. Next idiom is to take hold of. Take hold of, it means pakad lena. Once you are determined to do something, after repeated failures, he decided to take hold of the situation in his own hands. Next is to get down. The most common use is to get down on one's knees. He got down on his knees to propose to her. The next use is to go mad, to go crazy. There can be certain situations in life when there's too much of tension which one can't bear, one tends to go mad. Something that is very exceptional, something where you cannot tolerate it. Some people, they are so fastidious about cleanliness that when they enter the house, when all the things are in a mess, they tend to go mad. Next use is to lose sight of. You must have heard the elders in your family saying, please do not lose sight of your goal. It is very important to cherish your values. Whatever we are determined to do, one should not lose sight of that thing. the last uses to make a mess. Make a mess, confusion. The young lady does not lead a orderly life, and she tends to make a mess of everything. Some people, they lead very indisciplined life. They generally make a mess of everything. Then I come to the D part, that is the comprehension part. First, and then he would lift up the picture and drop it dash dash while he would dance round and hinder them. Read the above passage and answer the questions given below. I come to the first question. What happened to the frame when Uncle Podger lifted the picture? It so happened that the frame came out of the picture. Second, how did Uncle Podger get his finger cut? When Uncle Podger was trying to save the glass, he got his finger injured. Next is, why did he need the handkerchief? He needed the handkerchief to protect his finger. Where was his handkerchief lying? His handkerchief was lying in the pocket of his coat. Where did he send all the others? He sent all the others in search of his coat. What sort of situation was created when Uncle Podger's finger was cut? The situation was chaotic. It was full of confusion when Uncle Podger's finger was cut, because all things, suddenly everything halted. It came to a stop. And the next is, make a pressé of the above passage and give it a suitable title. Now, student, for as far as this question pressé is concerned, I'll be taking up pressé writing, that is the new topic, very soon, and then we shall discuss it. Because in the meantime, in such a short time, I will not be able to give you all the rules of pressé writing and help you to form a proper pressé. Now, students, since the lesson is over, okay then, students, in my next lecture, I'll be taking up a new lesson. Thank you.